Grammy award-winning singer, songwriter, Melissa Manchester's here. Now, she and the Blue Note Orchestra will be performing at the Sheraton Waikiki this Friday and Saturday. Now, I'm sitting here because I have to keep Brooke on this side.
There's a slight restraining order that happened around the second break.
I have to be honest. Not gonna lie. We were in the newsroom this morning so excited. Ron was singing at his desk, but when she came in, she found out, I heard this scream.
She's like, punking me. I really did.
She's like, no, she's in studio? And I'm like, yes, she's in.
She's like, not right now, but she's coming. And I'm like, okay,
here we are. So blessed to have you. And it was funny because I was asking, hey, you've been to Hawaii before and you've been coming to the islands for a while.
Oh, for decades. Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed. I've been performing here for a long time.
And talk about the performance. What can people expect tonight? Because the Blue Note, it's a unique, wonderful venue.
It's unbelievable. These are kids from Citrus College. I've been associated with Citrus for many years, and they keep inviting me back. Their horn section is magnificent, and the string section are many people from the Hawaiian Phil. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be a massive sound out in the beautiful air. And the show starts at 7, mm-hmm. and some of the young singers will be singing with me and solo. And it's just wall-to-wall music. It's beautiful.
Oh, I love it. I love it. And we were talking about this, and the last thing we were talking about, Chicago. All these great sounds that are still, I mean, hits notes now today. And do you see that response where you go? I mean, people just love and vibe with your music.
They do, and that's a real blessing because the songs capture moments in their lives, and so songs become part of the interior landscape of a person's life.
Oh, it's all over my landscape. All over my landscape.
And talk about that. I mean, for you, because you actually learned some of her songs.
Midnight Blue.
Yes, Midnight Blue.
Yes, Ice Castle.
Yes,
anyone?
TBS of Love.
Call in, mm-hmm. people.
That's right, exactly.
Yeah, I mean, iconic.
Iconic.
What do you love the most about performing here in Hawaii after all of the years that you've come here? Is there something about Hawaii that every time you're like, oh, I'm going to Hawaii?
Well, A, that it's always outdoors in this air.
Right.
A-I-R. Underscore. It's magnificent. The aloha spirit is so real. People are just so warm and so open to listening and relaxing and just being part of the moment.
Yeah, it fits with your vibe.
Yeah, mm-hmm. and to now share songs from the new album, my 20th album, You Gotta Love the Life, is so thrilling. And to have it played by these monster musicians from Citrus is just such a major blessing.
I gotta ask about that 20th album.
Yes.
I mean, that is a testament, but I mean, you work. I mean, you're writing these songs.
Yes.
I mean, is it a love? Is it a challenge? 20 albums. I mean, talk about the journey with that.
Well, this is my first album in 10 years of original songs.
Oh.
And I took time off. And then when I came back, I realized that the industry had changed. Mm-hmm. And it was my students who said, you need to do crowdfunding and we will help you. And I said, great. What is that? And so they did. One of my students from USC, University of Southern California, helped me to create crowdfunding and plus on this beautiful album, I really wanted to return to how I made albums in the first place. Live musicians and great artists showed up.
Yeah,
I see.
Unbeknownst, Stevie
Al
Wonder
Drew,
and
Kev Moe.
That's right,
Stevie Wonder,
Dave Koz. It was unbelievable.
Talk about that collaboration and them wanting to come and work with you and be on this album.
Well, it wasn't planned. I mean, once they found out that I was in the studio recording with beautiful musicians, I was getting phone calls, or my co-producer Terry Wallman was reaching out to them.
Right.
Saying, would you be part of this? And they all said yes. So I mean, the blessings were falling out of the sky. Mm-hmm. It was incredible.
I love it.
Yeah.
You know, you talked a little bit about your students, and can you also talk about that? Because you're an inspiration, you know, to so many musicians out there that want to sing, that want to songwrite, that want to put that together. Your students now, being kind of a teacher, how is that and passing it on to the next generation?
Well, I'll tell you what, with the Blue Note Orchestra, it's a blessing because we are setting very high expectations for these student musicians. And they are raising themselves way up and beyond to exceed these expectations. And they play these hard charts, not just mine, but others, that they are so spectacular and they become... They take on the countenance of being a professional because that's what's expected of them.
Right.
And this is the world they're going into.
Yeah.
And they are being trained so magnificently by Bob Slack, who's the dean at Citrus, and Alan Waddington, and it's just thrilling to be a part of that, and you see the light coming
right.
off of their faces.
You get so worried because they say, oh, we're cutting arts, we're cutting music
yes.
in schools, and
yes.
you think there's just not going to be a generation
Don't
that's
even get
learning.
Me started. I'm a huge proponent of alternative public education because mm-hmm. I went to the High School of Performing Arts in New York City, the mm-hmm. Fame School,
yes.
where half of your day is academics and half of your day is your craft. And it's all about discipline. You know, people think it's play school, but it's all about discipline
right.
yes.
that no matter whether you become an artist or whether you become a plumber,
you
it doesn't matter.
Skill.
You know what internal
right.
discipline is like.
Right.
So it's really thrilling.
Should we just cancel the rest of the show? I just want to sit here
I'm
and
good.
Talk to her.
I have nowhere else to go, and I don't know anybody except you.
Well, speaking of go, again, right. we're going to get you to go down, get to Friday, Saturday,
yes,
right?
Yes, Friday, Saturday at 7 o'clock at the Sheraton Waikiki. It'll be magnificent.
It's like you said, a beautiful venue, a beautiful
I've
orchestra.
I've not seen it because I don't live here anymore, but I've heard wonderful things.
Well, we're going to get you down this Friday and Saturday. You're going to go check
yes.
it out.
Really?
Yes, let's go. You'll be my date.
It's fantastic. Sing
okay.
along.
We will.
You'll know the songs.
Thank you for coming in.
Aloha.
Isn't this great?